It is said the brick-making machine was donated to the Rwenzori region ex-combatants in fulfillment of a presidential pledge in 2014, a project aimed at boosting their livelihoods. The beneficiaries say ever since the machine was given to them, they have not used it. The machine was left at Kasese Central Police Station for safe custody, where it has spent almost 1 year.
Choma chile ha polisi, e choma chamaro o maka gumu ne kichwek. E choma chile nituo, it is good for to be spoiled.
One of the beneficiaries, Wilson Muganiha, says they need financial facilitation to get the project started. Ronald Sekatawa, the Amnesty Commission Rwenzori Region Coordinator, says they are worried that the machine that was intended to assist the ex-combatants might wear out even before it is put to use.
That machine has been lying for so long at the police station in Kasese. Even us, we are not happy with that delay, but that's where I base to appeal to His Excellency the President to come in and help the reintegration program of Amnesty Commission as pledged in 2016 to the people of Rwenzori region. We as a commission, we are still committed to fulfill our constitutional mandate as it is in our constitution. But currently, we have been undercapped by funds.
Sekatawa says over 100 beneficiaries have been trained in the first and second phases, but cannot proceed to the third phase due to lack of facilitation. He has asked for government intervention.
Call upon the Minister of Internal Affairs, General Kaindo Tafire, the Permanent Secretary, General Musanyufu, to come in and see how this project can be pushed in to go ahead. Otherwise, the machine is ready and it was bought by the ministry, and the commission has done its part by training, and we have so far run 2 trainings.
The interlocking brick making machine was meant to help the ex-combatants and the communities that host them to improve their entrepreneurship skills. Report by Robert Kule for the news in Kasese.